पॉसिबिलिटी कर्व और द प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी फ्रंटियर. बेसिकली द प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी कर्व शोज various combination of two goods which an economy can produce with the given resources and technology. Okay, simply it's a curve like we have already done that. Curve itself is a representation of the various variables. So here production of good X and production of good Y are the two variables. So it is representing that how many combinations of these two goods you can produce in an economy when your resources are fixed and your technology remains constant. When you have to define the production possibility curve, these words are to be mentioned. These are the key words. Combination of two goods which an economy can produce with given resources and technology, right? Now we'll just move on to the diagrammatic representation of this particular curve. Suppose an economy is producing two goods, say wheat and say rice. Again, x-axis shows the units of wheat produced, y-axis shows the units of rice produced. Suppose my economy is operating at this particular point. Say I'm producing 100 goods of 100 units of wheat and say 200 units of rice. This is first combination showing 100 units of wheat and 200 units of rice. Like suppose I want to increase the production of wheat. So I need to move on to point B on the curve. Say maybe now I am able to produce 150 units of rice and maybe say 100 units of 150 units of wheat and maybe say 100 units of rice. So again it can be depicted 150 and 100. Similarly, moving on to point C, if I want to increase the production of good Y, then say I am able to produce 50 units of wheat and say 250 units of rice. So again this combination can be written as 50 and 250. So these are the various combinations which are lying on a particular production possibility curve, and these are the number of units which an economy can produce for good X and good Y. Again, as we have already discussed, that curve basically gives us two basic informations, or they are also known as the properties of the curve. The properties of PPC it has two basic properties. First, it is downward sloping, right? It depends on the relation between the two variables. And second, it is concave to origin, right? We have already discussed that any curve is downward sloping due to the inverse relation between the two variables. As we can see that when we shift from point A to point B or say to point C, the combinations production of one good increases and production of the other good reduces. Again, it is simple reason because the resources are limited. If I employ my resources for the production of one good, then the resources available to produce the other good reduce and the quantity of production of that particular good falls. Like you can simply imagine here that if you take the example of a field, suppose economy has a fixed area, it wants to increase the production of wheat, then less land area will be left to produce rice. So the production of rice will fall and vice versa. Basic thing we can understand, it's a downward sloping curve. Then second, concave to origin, right? We already discussed. So here, whenever you are explaining why it is downward sloping, you need to mention that it is due to the inverse relation between the production of good X and good Y, or maybe say wheat and rice, as we have taken here. And you also have to mention that if we increase the production of one good, say increase the production of X, so less resources are left to produce good Y. This is the reason, the basic reason why there is an inverse relation between the production of two goods. These are the keywords, you have to mention them whenever you have to explain this. Now for understanding the second property, right, the concave to origin, we already have discussed that it depends on the rate at which the slope is changing, right? And whenever the slope rises, when we move from one point to another, in that particular case, the curve is a concave curve. So the basic idea, basic reason I already know that its slope is rising.
So sir, can we say that it is due to inverse rising MRT?
This will be after this, na? It will be MRT only. Now we will discuss the reason about it. Okay, so I come to know that it is concave to origin. This we are discussing, the second property of PPC. And the reason, basic reason is due to the rising slope. Now to understand this concept, first I should know what is the slope of PPC. As discussed, slope of any curve is equal to delta y by delta x. That is change in the variable y and change in the variable x. Slope of PPC, if you look at good at on the y-axis, we are showing the units of a good y, and here we are showing the good x. So it is change in the quantity of y and change in the quantity of x. I'll make it a little simple to understand. Suppose this is the PPC. Say I am on a particular point, say A. The combinations are 20 and 30. And when I move on to another point B, say now the combinations are 21 and 28. Okay, so if I want to calculate the slope between point A and point B, I can use the formula. Just see the change in good y, delta y. The change in good y is 2, while the change in good x is 1. Right? So slope comes out to be 2 by 1, or I can better call it as 2 is to 1. Now basically, if you talk about the PPC, the slope of PPC has been given a specific name, that is MRT, that is marginal rate of transformation. So now we'll discuss specifically about the PPC, about the MRT, that why it is happening that MRT is rising or PPC is getting a concave shape. So first we'll understand the meaning of MRT. MRT is the marginal rate of transformation okay, and it is defined as the rate at which one good needs to be sacrificed to increase the production of the other good by one unit. When you are defining MRT, you write that it is the rate at which, basically it's a rate, this needs to be mentioned, it is the rate at which one good needs to be sacrificed to increase the production of the other good by one unit.